One way that Jesus seemed to like to teach was through illustrations, things like parables, and certainly as his followers, we can learn from his example and also try to be using modern illustrations to help the modern audience understand biblical truth a little better. For example, Jesus talked about how he stands at the door and knocks, things like at the door of our hearts, and knocks and says, "If any man will hear my voice and will open the door, I will come in and will sup with him," right? I'll hang out with him. I'll build that relationship with him. I'm standing at the door. I'm taking the initiative. I am knocking. It's not saying you must come to me. He says, "I've come to you and I've knocked on the door. I've taken the initiative. You just have to accept me into your home," things like that. Well, in a modern sense, we could use an illustration like Facebook. And I know Facebook is a little bit of a silly illustration, but in much the same way as Jesus took the initiative to knock on the doors of our hearts, people on Facebook can take the initiative and send out friend requests, and they can send them out as many times as they want. But the truth is, they will not become friends. They will not have that relationship status with that person until that person accepts their friend request. So just as the person has to accept the friend request, we actually have to accept Jesus into our life. He's already taken the initiative. He's standing at the door knocking, but we still have to accept him before he says he will come in and will commune with us, he'll fellowship with us, things like that. So with that in mind, we can use other illustrations. And one common one that I like to use is an XY graph. And you might think, how do you use an XY graph to illustrate the gospel? Well, a lot of times when I'll ask somebody, "Do you believe that you're going to heaven? And if so, why? Why do you believe you're going to heaven?" And most often I'll hear people say, "Yes, I think I'm going to heaven. And I think I'm going to heaven because I'm a pretty good person," right? I'm more of a good person. I've done more good than I have bad, right? So it's like they're looking at this and saying, "I'm still in the positive," right? I'm still up in the upper right corner of the quadrant. So I'm still in the positive. So I think I'm still worthy to go to heaven, opposed to being in the negative, which you would be unworthy. So I often use that as an illustration to say what the Bible actually says about, say, an XY quadrant, if we were going to apply biblical truths to that illustration. Well, the Bible says that we're all unworthy because we've all sinned. So let's say that Y0 is considered completely neutral. And let's say you're perfect, you've never sinned or anything like that. But then as soon as you sin, you go in the negative. Well, of course, many of us, all of us, have sinned multiple times. In fact, some people have sinned hundreds of thousands of times. So they are way down there in the lower quadrant. Now the question becomes, if sinning makes you go down, then does doing good make you go up? Well, that's a common misconception that people have about Christianity. It's probably because of all the religions out there that teach such things, but Christianity, the Bible itself, does not teach such things. It says many times, it's not by what you do that you become worthy. It's only by what Jesus did. So a lot of times I'll tell people that, you know, the Bible says, all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. We're no longer worthy to go to heaven. In fact, even if you keep all the commands, you do everything right, you do all these good things, you give all your money to the poor, whatever it might be. But the Bible says, but if you offend at one point, if you break just one command, if you sin just once, you're still unworthy. Right? That's what the Bible says. So this idea that sinning brings you down and doing good brings you back up is not what the Bible teaches. The Bible says you could do all the good in the world, but if you broke one command, you're still unworthy. In fact, it says, "He that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, to him it is a sin." So doing good is an expectation. That's what God expects us to do. It doesn't bring us up or more worthy. That's just a neutral. It's what we're expected to do. So it would be like plateauing on the XY graph when we do good. So with that in mind, this seems pretty helpless, right? Because when we sin, we go down, and all of us have sinned multiple times. But when we do good, it just kind of plateaus, of course, until we sin again, in which case we go down again. But with that in mind, it seems very helpless for humanity. And this is the problem of sin. Sin has separated us from God. We're no longer worthy to be in the presence of God's glory in heaven, giving us only one alternative. And of course, we can't earn our way back to God. So how did God fix this? If God loves us, then how did he save us? Well, he saved us by taking on flesh and becoming a human being, Jesus, of course, and dying on the cross for our sins. The wages of sin, the payment for sin, is death. It's not community service. It's not good works. It's death. And Jesus was the only one worthy to pay the penalty for our sins through his death. So Jesus willingly came and died on the cross for our sins so that we could have salvation. This is, of course, awesome for us because it's not like we can earn our way back to heaven, because if that was true, then none of us would be able to do it. But God himself came down and brought us to heaven. we are not worthy because of what we've done. We are only worthy by what Jesus has done. And just like I said with the Facebook illustration, Jesus has basically sent us a friend request. He's taken the initiative. He's knocked on the door of our hearts, but we still have to accept him. It says, "For by grace are you saved." Grace is something that you didn't earn, by faith and not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not by works, lest any man should boast. Right? So the Bible makes it very clear. We do not bring ourselves up. Only by what Jesus did can we have eternal life. It says the wages of sin, the payment for sin, is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. So that's the illustration that I like to use a lot of times. It's just to show them that, hey, doing good works does not bring us up higher. It just kind of plateaus us. Only by what Jesus did can we have eternal life.